We're given the definite integral of f of x from negative 2 to 4 equals 4, and the definite integral of f of x from negative 1 to 4 is equal to 5.5. So a couple things to notice here. First, we're integrating the same function, but the limits of integration are different. Here we're integrating from negative 2 to 4, where the value is positive 4, and here we're integrating from negative 1 to 4, and the value is 5.5. So notice how when the interval is larger, the value is smaller, and when the interval is smaller, the value is larger. This means f of x must be negative over part of the interval from negative 2 to negative 1. To illustrate this, let's begin by shading the area that would represent the value of this first definite integral, which should be the area bounded by the function and the x-axis over the interval from negative 2 to 4. Here's where x equals negative 2, and here's where x equals 4. Notice how from negative 2 to 1, the area would be below the x-axis, and therefore would have a negative value, and on the interval from negative 1 to 4, the area is above the x-axis, so the value would be positive. So again, the area that represents the value of this definite integral would be this shaded area here, where this would be negative and this would be positive. And now for the second definite integral, we'll shade the area bounded by the function on the x-axis over the interval from negative 1 to 4. Notice on this interval, the area is above the x-axis, which would be this area here. And again, our goal here is to find the value of the definite integral from negative 1 to 2 over this interval here. So to do this, we can take the value of this first definite integral over the interval from negative 2 to 4 and subtract the definite integral over the interval from negative 1 to 4 here. That will leave us with the value of the definite integral from negative 2 to 1. So again, this is going to be equal to the definite integral of f of x from negative 2 to 4 minus the definite integral of f of x from negative 1 to 4. Well, we know this first value is positive 4 minus, we know the second value is 5.5, leaving us with negative 1.5 as the value of the definite integral of f of x from negative 2 to negative 1. Going back to our graph just for a moment, notice how this area is below the x-axis, and therefore we do expect the value to be negative, which it is. Now I do want to point out, this idea is true for any function that's integrable over the given intervals, but I think this graph does provide a nice illustration. I hope you found this helpful.